Hi everyone, welcome back to Online Classroom Jeku Duo. In this video, we are going to look at nutrient cycle in an ecosystem. What is nutrient cycle? Actually, nutrients can be obtained from a very balanced ecosystem. All the living things, us included, we use these nutrients, and after we use it, we actually return it back to the environment. And then we use it again, and then we return it again. That is why it is called a cycle. Okay, we take it and we put it back. And after that, we take it back to use it again and we return. So that is a cycle. In Form 1, you have learned about water cycle, carbon cycle, and also oxygen cycle. So in Form 2, we are going to look at the role of living things in the three cycles that you have learned about in Form 1. Let's take a look at water cycle first. What is the role of plants in water cycle? Well, the water is absorbed by the roots of plants. If you look at the picture here on the bottom part of the left-hand side, okay, the water is absorbed by the roots of plants, and through a process called the transpiration, the water is returned back into the environment. And also the leaves that fall from the tree will cover the surface of the earth. And why is this important? It will slow down the process of evaporation, meaning that the soil will not become dry too quickly. Okay, so that's the role of the plants. And also, how about the roots of the plants? It plays a role too. The roots will hold the soil tightly and make the structure of the soil compact. And now, why is this important? Because when the structure of the soil is compact, then the flow of water underground will be slowed down. And when the flow of water is slow, that will prevent soil erosion and hence prevent landslide. So that is important. How about animals? Well, the animals will carry out respiration, which is breathing in and breathing out, defecation, which is when we do our big business in the bathroom, and also excretion, sweating, and urination. All of this process will increase the water content in the atmosphere. Okay? How about carbon cycle and oxygen cycle? As we have talked about respiration in the water cycle, plants and animals both actually carry out as respiration. Respiration meaning we breathe in and we breathe out. And it's a process where we use oxygen. We take oxygen from the environment and then we give carbon dioxide to the environment. Okay? Well, what happens when plants or animals die? When living things die, there will be a process of decaying by the bacteria and fungi in the soil, and this process also takes away oxygen and give back carbon dioxide to the environment. There's only one process that is carried out by the green plants called the photosynthesis. This is the only process where it takes away carbon dioxide and it gives oxygen back. Now, can you see why green plants is so important to us? The sad fact is there's a lot of human activity that will disrupt the nutrient cycle that we have just looked at. Some of these activities are unrestricted logging. When we chop down trees without restriction, what happens is we take away so many green plants that can carry out the only process that we talked about just now that take away carbon dioxide and give oxygen. And so the nutrient cycle will be disrupted if we do unrestricted logging. And also the burning of fossil fuels will contribute to the increase of carbon dioxide in our atmosphere. Next will be the overconsumption of water resources. When there is a waste of water, we took away water way too quickly, then we can't give it back to the environment again, and that will cause some problem and trouble as well. So how do we solve this problem? Some of the ways that we can solve the interference to the nutrient cycle will be create planned agricultural systems, use public transport so we can reduce the car and reduce the burning of fossils. Next, we can collect rainwater for our daily use. And after we chop down some trees, don't forget to replant those trees. And finally, we need to tighten the laws so that all of us can be more responsible in our using of the natural resources, the nutrient that we are blessed with. Okay? So that's all from JQDO in this video. I shall see you in the next video. Bye!
If you have learned something new from this video, don't forget to like and subscribe.